Hi everybody, welcome to the lecture in the experimental design and data analysis. For this lecture, we will talk about the statistical inference for true sample. For this statistical, we will talk about the hypothesis test and confidence interval for the true sample. That's why we focus on the mean, test on the mean, test on the variance, and test on the proportion. The first of all, for this, you consider on the mean. That's right. If we consider, right, we have two population, population one and population two. The assumption that the variable x1 and x2 is a random sample from population one and two is from population two. Two population is independent. That's right. Population independent. And also we assume that the two population are normal. That's right. Are normal. This is normal. These two population normal, which had the variance one for sample one, mu one for sample one, and variance two, mu two, and the variable is x1 and x2. Okay. The estimated value of the difference between mean of sample one and mean of sample two is expressed by E x bar one minus x bar two equal to x bar one minus E x bar two. This is equal to mu one minus mu two. For the variance of the x bar 1 minus x bar 2 is equal to V x bar 1 plus V x bar 2 equal to variance 1 divided by N1 plus variance 2 divided by N2. N1, N2 is the number of the sample. Okay, the quantity that we use to hypothesis test, we use for the determine the confidence interval. What do we use? The set variable or set test, set statistic. That is the difference in the sample mean is different in the population mean and divided by the square root of the variance divided by it. So this is for the standard normal distribution with mean is equal to zero, variance equal to one. Okay, if we consider the hypothesis test for different in mean of the two sample, as I talked to you from the last lecture, so for the known hypothesis, we set mu one minus mu two equal to data zero. Data zero, and then the test statistic set zero that's equal to mu x bar one minus x bar two equal to data zero divided by square root of variance one divided by n one plus variance two divided by n two. This for it zero. This for test statistic, and also for hypothesis test we classify in three kind of alternative hypothesis. That's alternative hypothesis. The first one is true side hypothesis. That's S1 mu 1 minus mu 2 not equal data 0. That's right, not equal to data 0. For this, right, we have classified the, this is the rejection region. Right, this is the critical region is set 0. For set alpha over 2, this is the critical value. And this is the critical value at the lower, this is is lower this upper region. That's right. If you set zero, locate between minus set alpha over two and set alpha over two, we accept the null hypothesis. That's right. If set alpha set zero, locate in this area or this area, or that mean if set zero lower than minus alpha over two and greater than set alpha over two, we reject the hypothesis. Hypothesis. We reject that means we accept it one. Okay, this is for two side test. For one side test, we separate into right the upper and lower. For the upper, that's right. This is the rejection region. This is the acceptance region. The rejection region is with set greater than set alpha. This is the set alpha. That's right. This is the lower region. That's right. This lower. This is the rejection region. So rejection region minus set alpha. This is the critical value. That's right. If set zero is less than minus set alpha, okay, we reject H zero except S one. If set zero greater than set alpha, we reject H zero except S one. This is for three kind of hypothesis test of the mean. Of the mean. For this case, we use for the case that the normal, but if we use our technique in this class, the data should be normal. That's the first step. You have to check this normal or not by the proper report that I talked to you for last two lecture. Okay, for this equation, we consider this. We use the variant of the population is known. The variant of the population is known. If you know the variant, we will use statistic for this case. Statistic for this case. Okay, for this case, we do the example. That's right. For this case, we would like to produce or to develop primer pay. That's a drying time of the primer pay. For this case, we have two formula. That's right. Two formula or two formulation of the pain test. We have formula one. That's our formulation one and formulation two. Formulation one is the own technique or the standard chemistry, and formulation one has a new drying ingredient. So for one is the standard, but two is a new ingredient add to the old one. That's right. This the new we develop to reduce the drying time. That's right. Because the drying is less or drying is lower value. Drying rate is lower value. It's good for the process because it save the money, save energy, something like this. Okay, from the experience, it's known that the standard deviation of drying time is 8 minutes. That's right. And this inherent variability should be unaffected by the addition of new ingredient. What does this mean? Does it mean in the formulation one and formulation two had the same standard deviation? Sigma equal to 8 and variance equal to 8 squared, like this. For this case, no variability. That's right. No variability of the standard deviation if you change the new ingredient or you add the new ingredient to the formula. That's right. Okay. For this case, 10 specimen or 10 sample are paired with formulation one, and another 10 specimen are paired with formulation two. That's right. For N1, N2 equal to 10. And total is 20 specimen are paired in random order. That's right. Okay, the two sample average drying time are x bar 1 is 121 minutes, x bar 2 is 112 minutes. That's right. With this x bar 1 and x bar 2. Okay, what conclusion can the product developer draw about the effectiveness of the new ingredient? You would like to check the new ingredient is had effectiveness or not. That's right. By using the alpha equal to 0.05. For this case, you know the population standard deviation, and then you know the population variance. You can use this formula. That's right. You can use this equation. Okay. And you know x bar 1, you know x bar 2. We would like to check the effectiveness of the adding new chemical. For this here, the adding new chemical. That's right. We would like to test on mu 1 minus mu 2 equal to 0, or mu 1 equal to mu 2. And half-field hypothesis test mu 1 greater than mu 2 because we would like to check the new formulation it had higher effectiveness. That's right. Higher effectiveness than the formula 1. That means mu 1 greater than mu 2. That's right. If mu 1 greater than mu 2, that means the formulation 2 is the best. That's right. It's better than formulation 1 because the mean is less than mu 1. That's right. Okay. For this case, we would like to test mu 1 equal to mu 2 or not, or mu 1 greater than mu 2. That's right. For this case, the objective we would like to accept S1. That's right. We would like to get the mu 1 or formulation 2. Formulation 2 is the better. Right. But we have to check. From the mean, you can see that the mean 2 is less than mean 1. That's the default value. Okay, it may be less than, but from the static, what is the conclusion? Because this value come from 10 sample. That's right. From 10 sample, they are the variability. That's right. Okay, we would like to check. This is mu 1 is greater than mu 2 or not. That's right. Okay, for S1, we will reject S0 if the new ingredient reduce mean drying time. Okay, we use alpha equal to 0.05 and the test statistic. You know x bar 1, you know x bar 2, you know variant 1, you know variant 2, you know N1, you know N2, you can calculate such zero. So you can calculate such zero. And then the critical region, did it for two side test, the critical region for this disease set alpha over 2. Sorry. This is one side test, that's okay. One side test. This is the rejection region. That's like at set 0.05. That's like for if set 0 greater than set 0.05, this you can calculate by Excel or table. That's like it's 1.645. If set 0 greater than 1.645, that means you reject S0 and accept S1, that's mu 1 greater than mu 2. Okay, and then you substitute unknown value to this equation. You get set 0 equal to 2.52. That means 2.52 greater than 1.645. That means reject S0, you accept S1. What does it mean? This means that the new ingredient that you add to the chemical for the painting, that's right, for the painting, you get the drying less, it reduced. That's one mu 2 less than mu 1. This is the effectiveness of the formulation 2 is higher than formulation 1. Okay, for this case, you also test the statistic by check the p-value. That's right. For this p-value, one side test, you calculate based on 1 minus the probability of the set 0. This is the probability of set 0. That's right. Or Excel, you use norm distribution. That's right. Norm is this of 2.25. Then you get the p-value is 0.00959. That's right, not 59. Because the p-value is greater than or less than alpha, you have to reject. That's right, less than alpha, you have to reject. See, that's the conclusion by p-value or critical region is the same conclusion. And also for this case, we can calculate the number of the sample or the size of the sample. For this case, the first you use the operating characteristic curve. For this case, you know N1 equal to N2, that's equal to N. And you know D is the absolute difference between the mean, the mean of sample and the population divided by square root of variance 1 plus variance 2. You know D, you know beta, you can list from graph to calculate N. Or you know N, you know D, you can calculate beta. Beta is the type 2 error. That's like the percent error that we accept S0, but S0 is not true. Okay, this is the example of the curve for two sides with alpha 0.05. This is two sides for 0.01 alpha. This is one side for 0.05 alpha. This is one side for 0.01 alpha. Okay. In the case of N1 is not equal to N2. N1 is not equal to N2. For this case, we can use the N from the characteristic curve, the N from characteristic curve, for the calculate for this. Okay, if we know D, that's right, know D, you can calculate N1, N2 to obtain the specified beta we get at trial, N1 and N2. For this case, you can assume N1, N2. N1, N2, and then you calculate N. That's right, you calculate N. You check from curve, you get the beta. That's right, you get the beta. Okay, for the first one, you... Right, we show to you. Okay, sorry. We use the trial and error for N1 is not equal to N2. For this case, that's right, the first step, you assume N1, N2. You assume N1, N2. And then you know N, you calculate N. You know N from this, and you know D, you can estimate beta from the curve. Beta on the curve, that's right. Okay, if beta from the curve is beta theta, it's not the same beta. You assume N1, N2 again. That's right. You assume N2, N1, and again until you get beta equal to beta theta. Beta is the specified beta that you would like to determine. And beta star means estimated from assume N1 and N2. That's right. After you assume N1, N2. Calculate N from this. Calculate N from this. You know N and you know D. You open from the curve. You know D. You know N. You estimate beta. And then you check beta star with the specified beta. It's not the same. You back to assume N1 and N2 again. That's right. N1 and N2 again. Then calculate N. Open the curve. Find beta. If beta star is not equal to specify beta, you assume N1 and N2 again. For this case, we call this trial and error. That's right. Trial and error technique. You can use the solver in Excel to help you. That's right. Or optimization technique for that case. You assume N1, N2 until you get beta from specify equal to beta that you estimate from the curve. This is for the technique to calculate N if N1 is not equal to N2. Okay. For this example, we consider the pain drying time experiment from the first example. If the two different in mean drying time is much at 10 minutes, if the difference between mu1 and mu2 is 10 minutes, determine the sample size required to detect the difference with probability at least 0.9. For this case, 0.9. Okay. The estimate value, the absolute mu1 minus mu2 is equal to 10 divided by variance 1 squared divided plus variance 2 squared. It takes square root of this. You get 0.88. As you know, D is 0.88. And then the probability test for this case is 90%. 90% for this case mean 10% for except H0 if H0 is not true. We have beta equal to 0.1. That's right. Beta equal to 0.1. For this case, you know D equal to 0.88. And you know beta is 0.1. That's right. The cross is here that you get the N is between 10 and 15. That's right. 10 and 15. You interpret between 10 and 15. You get N is approximately 11. For this case, you need N is 11. That's right. N is 11 with the probability that at least 90% of beta equal to 0.1 for this case. And also for this, we can use the formula to calculate N. The period you use the curve. And also you can use the formula to determine the sample size for two side tape. This is two side tape. You use N approximately sat alpha over 2 plus sat beta of this square plus variance 1 plus variance 2 divided by delta minus beta 0. That's that beta 0. And also you can estimate the beta type error by this formula. This comes from the probability of this term minus probability of this term. That's right, probability of this term. And for the one-side test or one-side alternative hypothesis test, N is similar to the previous equation except sat alpha. For the two-side test, that should be sat alpha over 2. For one side test, that should be sat alpha only. You can use this formula to calculate N. That's right. For this case, N1 equal to N2. This formula is except for N1 equal to N2. Okay, and also we check with this, with the example one. Right, the probability is 0.9, beta is 0.1. That's right, delta 0 is 0. For the delta is 10. Alpha 0.05. For this case, we test on one side test. That's right. One side test, we use this formula. Okay. You know beta, sat beta or sat 0.1, 1.28. That's right. Sat alpha, 0.05, 1.6, 1.28. Variant 1, variant 2 is the same, a square. That's right. Delta minus delta 0. Delta equal to 10, delta equal to 0. You get 11. This the number of the sample is similar to the determination by curve. That's right, determination by curve. Okay, for the next, previously we talked about the hypothesis test, and also we can use the confidence interval to test, that's right, to test for the two side. If you test on the two side test, you can use the interval or confidence interval to determine the hypothesis test for two side test. Okay, for this case, we use the set value. That's right. We would like to calculate the probability of this set value greater than minus set alpha over 2, less than set alpha over 2, equal to 1 minus alpha. This is a probability. That's right, probability, 1 minus alpha. And then you rearrange this term, you get probability of mu 1 minus mu 2 greater than this term. That's right, x bar 1 minus x bar 2 minus this parameter. For the upper is quite similar, except the upper it should be plus, the lower should be minus. Another term is the same. This is the probability at mu 1 minus mu 2 greater than the lower limit and less than the upper limit with 1 minus alpha percent of probability. And from this, you can also use this formula to calculate the upper and lower limit or confidence interval. Confidence interval with the 1 minus alpha multiplied 100, you get percent confidence interval of mu 1 minus mu 2. It's mu 1 minus mu 2. This is the lower limit due to the minus, upper limit due to the plus sign. That's right. The another is the same. Right. For this case, this is the confidence interval for the variance known. Your data is known variance. Right. Known variance. And okay. Tensile strength tests were performed on two different grades of aluminum spare used in manufacturing of the wing of commercial transport aircraft. For this case, we have two different grade of aluminum. That's right. That aluminum used for the wing. That's right. Used for the wing in the aircraft. Okay. From the past experience with the spare manufacturing process and the testing procedure, the standard deviation of tensile strength are assumed to be known. For the case, you know the standard deviation. The two data obtained from the follow. That's right. At the follow, right? N1 equal to 10. X bar 1, sigma 1 standard deviation. N bar X. N2, X bar 2, sigma 2 for this case. And mu 1, mu 2 is the two mean tensile strength of population mean of the two grade. Okay, we may find 95% confidence interval on the difference of the mean. For this case, we would like to determine the 95% confidence interval of the mu 1 minus mu 2. You use this formula. That's right. You use the formula. You know X bar 1, you know X bar 2. You know sigma 1, sigma 2, N1, N2. You only calculate set alpha over 2. That's right, set alpha over 2. We use alpha equal to 0.1. Alpha over 2 is 0.025. 0.05. That's right, okay. X bar 1, X bar 2. Set alpha over 2 is set 0.05, 1.64. That's right, it's variant 1, variant 2. Okay, the subject of this, you get the value of the mu 1. Minus mu 2 is between 12.22 and 13.95. For this case, you can see that two side have the positive value. That's why two side is positive value. You can conclude that the mu 1 is not equal to mu 2. That's why if you positive, it's also positive. Two side is also positive. That means this mu 1 is not equal to mu 2, and this indicates that mu 1 greater than mu 2 because you get positive value. That's right. This is that mu 1 is not equal to mu 2, and also you can conclude that mu 1 greater than mu 2. If the confidence interval is between minus and also minus, that's right. Mu 1 minus mu 2 is also not the same mu 2. That's right. Mu 1 is not the same mu 2, not equal to mu 2. And for this case, you can conclude that mu 1 greater than mu 2 because it's a negative value. Mu 1 minus mu 2 is negative value, that's mu 1 less than mu 2. Okay, this was the third, that's right. The difference is between minus and positive, negative and positive. For this case, we can conclude that mu 1 equal to mu 2. That's right, mu 1 equal to mu 2. The error is conclude 0 also for this. And the choice of the sample size, if the standard deviation sigma 1, sigma 2 are known, and the two samples, psi 1 and psi 2 are equal, we can determine the sample size required so that the error estimate for that. You can use this equation to estimate the number of the sample. n equal to sat alpha over 2 divided by error variant 1 plus variant 2 multiplied for this term. So, okay, previously we talked about two sides. And then if we would like to talk about the one side for confident bound, the side equation is quite similar to this. Yes, sir. For lower is sat alpha, for upper is sat alpha, lower is minus sat alpha, this sat alpha. Okay. This is for one side test. For the lower, this for upper, for lower. Yes, sir. This is for lower confidence, this for upper confidence. And the next case, for the variant with unknown, yes, right. We classify into case, variant equal or not equal. Yes, right. For the unknown variant, and if you know that the variant is equal, the known hypothesis is the same. Yes, right. For two side test, mu1 not equal to mu2 or mu1 minus mu2 equal to delta 0. Mu1 minus mu2 is not equal to delta 0. And this is the expected value of the difference in mean. And this is a variant of difference in mean. Sorry for this case. And then for this case, the hypothesis test is maybe use the pool estimate of the variant. Because this is, if we don't know the variant, we can estimate the pool of the variant by S squared P. S squared P is the pool estimate of the sample of the variant of the sample. Calculated by this formula. We using the variant of sample one, variant of sample two, N1 and N2. And this is the pool estimator of the variant. And then you use the T distribution for this case. If you don't know variant, and if the difference of the mean, the variant is equal, we use the T distribution from this equation by using the degree of freedom N1 plus N2 minus two degree of freedom. And the null hypothesis, we set mu1 minus mu2 equal to delta 0. And three cases of alternative hypothesis, that's I show in this slide. Right, the same. For S1, mu1 minus mu2 is not equal to 0, we have two regions, that's right, the upper and lower region. Upper and lower region. This is the acceptance region. This is the rejection region. This is the rejection region. If T0 greater than T alpha over 2, we see T alpha over 2 N1 plus N2 minus 1, minus 2, sorry. This is the upper rejection region. And this is the lower rejection region. This is for two sides. For one side, we reject S1. We reject S0 when T0 greater than T alpha N plus N2 minus 1. That's right. This is the lower, this upper. This conclusion for the T case, for this case, the known unknown variant, but for variant 1 equal to variant 2. We use this formula and hypothesis test. Okay, for this, we will use the example of two catalysts being analyzed to determine how they affect the mean yield of chemical process. We would like to compare the two types of catalyst with effect to the chemical yield. Okay. The catalyst one is currently in use, and catalyst two is acceptable of a new catalyst that we would like to compare with the old one. That's right. We use the new catalyst is catalyst two compared to the old catalyst is catalyst one. That's right. Since the catalyst two is cheaper, we have to check or compare with the catalyst one. If you check the yield is higher catalyst one or the same or similar to catalyst, okay, we can use the catalyst 2 instead of catalyst 1 because it's cheaper. That's right. Okay, we have to check by the testing hypothesis. Okay, for this case, it should be adopted and providing it does not change the process yield. If catalyst 2 and does not change the process yield compared to process 1, okay, we accept to use the catalyst 2 instead of catalyst 1. Okay, a test is run in a pilot pan and result in the data shown in the next slide. Okay, the question is there any difference between the mean yield? That means mu1 minus mu2 equal to 0 or not for that case. Using alpha equal to 0.05. And also we assume this work is equal variant. For equal variant and unknown variant, we use this formula and use this technique. That's right, use this formula, use this technique. Okay, this is the data. Catalyst 1 and catalyst 2, this data is process yield. This is the process yield. The average process yield for the first one is 92.255.7533. This is the value of sample, standard deviation of sample, sorry. For this case, we would like to test mu 1 minus mu 2 equal to 0, or mu 1 is not equal to mu 2 by using alpha equal to 0.05. This two side test. That's right. Two side test. This is the rejection region. Set alpha over 2. That's right. This is, sorry, t alpha over 2. This is minus t alpha over 2. That's right. This is if the T0 less than T alpha over 2. T alpha over 2 means T0.025. If T0 less than minus T0.025, degree of freedom N1 plus N2 minus 2, that's 14. For this case, the value is minus 2.145. And the upper limit is T0 greater than T0.025 and 14 degree of freedom, you get 2.14. This is the upper, it's lower. If your T value is between the two values, okay, we accept at zero. If T zero less than lower critical or upper critical, we reject. Okay, and then you calculate. For this case, you have to calculate SP first. SP calculate from this formula. And then substitute N1, N2, valiant 1, valiant 2, you get 7.3. You get 7.3, and then you take square root, you get 2.7. This is SP. And then calculate T0. Calculate T0 from this formula. Substitute X bar 1, X bar 2, SP, N1, N2. You get the way it minus 0.35. That's right. The upper and lower region is between minus 2.14. That's right, minus 2.14. This is 2.145. Okay, but this value minus 0.35 is located between these two values that we conclude that we accept at zero. That means mu1 equal to mu2. Mu1 equal to mu2. What does it mean? If mu1 equal to mu zero, that means the yield of the two catalysts is the same. The yield of the two catalysts is the same. What your decision? What is your decision? You have to use catalyst 2 instead of catalyst 1 because catalyst 2 is cheaper. We use catalyst 2 and then we get the same yield. That's right. We can get the same yield and we save the money for that case. And also for this case, you can check by the T value for two side test. That's right, T value for two side test is, you know, the T0 is 0.35, and then you take the T distribution of this. That's right, you get 0.73. P value is 0.73. That means it's higher than alpha we accept. That's right, higher than we alpha we accept. Okay, you can check with the critical region of P value. If P value higher than alpha, you accept at zero. If P value less than alpha, you reject at zero. This is the conclusion. Okay. For this case, we also show the normal probability plot. You can see that the slope of the graph is quite close, but not the same, but it's close or similar. That's right. We can conclude that it too mean it is the same. That's right. Because the slope of the curve is close together. That's right, close together. That is no different. Okay. Okay, for the next case, for the variant unknown, but the variant of sample 1 and sample 2 is not equal. It's not equal. This also use the t-statistic, but you have to modify the t-statistic formula. This is, for the previous, we use SP, but for this not, we use S square or variant 1 and variant 2. But when you calculate the t-statistic or t-critical, we use the degree of freedom is different, right? The t is quite similar, except this is S1 and S2. That's right. For previous, we use this, that SP multiplied by the square root of this term. But for the variant is not equal, we use T is this equation and the degree of freedom to calculate set alpha. Use the degree of freedom follow this formula. You just did the degree of freedom. That's right. This is the degree of freedom, and this is the t-test. Okay, for the example, we calculate the arsenic concentration in the public drinking water supply is a potential health risk. We determine the arsenic concentration. That's right. For this case, an article report in Arizona Republic report the drinking water arsenic concentrations in the unit of ppb. Ppb is parts per billion. Parts per billion. For 10 metropolit for any community and 10 community in the rural Arizona. We have to put that in metropolit of Phoenix and rural Arizona area. For each plate, we select from 10. That's right. 10 metropolit and 10 community. The number is the concentration of arsenic. That's right. Also, for this, we calculate X bar. For each number, we get 12.5 and calculate standard deviation of sample 1, we get 7.63. And also you average it, we get 27.5 and 15.3 is the standard deviation. Okay. Okay, for this case, we need to determine if there is any difference in mean of arsenic. Okay, we would like to test the arsenic concentration between the metropolit and rural is the same or not. That's right, it's the same or not. Mu 1 equal to mu 2 or mu 1 is not equal to mu 2. Okay, for this case, we plot the normal probability plot, normal probability plot of the two data. We can see that it's different slope, quite different. That's right, quite different. For that case, we can conclude, and we can indicate that the two data is not the same. That's right. We have to check this in the statistic technique by hypothesis test to confirm. And also for this case, it's normal because each curve is close to the linear. That is normal. If the normal, we can use the technique that we study in this class. Okay, the first step, the parameter that we iterate to determine is mu 1 minus mu 2 equal to 0. And new hypothesis is mu 1 minus mu 2 equal to 0 or mu 1 equal to mu 2. And S1 is mu 1 not equal to mu 2. We use alpha 0.05. For this case, the problem statement did talk to you. For this case, in the common sense for engineer, we use 95% confidence interval or 0.05 alpha. And the statistic, we use this. Okay. And then you calculate the degree of freedom. For this case, we substitute variant 1, variant 2, and 1, and 2. You get 13.2, approximately 30. You know the variant, you know the degree of freedom is 13, and then you calculate the critical region. Critical region. The lower is minus alpha over 2, degree of freedom is 30. That's right. It's it. This is the upper 2.16 and minus 2.16 is minus 2.16 and 2.16. If your T0 is less than minus 2.16 or greater than 2.16, you will reject at zero. If the value is between minus 2.16 and 2.16, you accept at zero. Okay, then you calculate T0 star, T0 minus 2.77. Minus 2.77 is less than, it's located in this area, less than minus 2.16, you have to reject at zero. You reject at zero mean mu 1, you know, not equal to mu 2 or the arsenic concentration in metropolis is not equal to in the rural aside for the critical region. Okay, and also you can calculate this by the p value. P value is approximately 0.016 that you calculate from the t distribution of t0 aside, degree of freedom and two side test. 0.016, 0.016 is less than alpha. You have to reject. That's right. It's less than alpha because alpha is 0.05. Okay, and also we can calculate the number of sample size for the case of variant 1 equal to variant 2. For this case, variant 1 equal to variant 2 and N1 equal to N2. That's right. N1 equal to N2. You have to know D value is different in the two mean and sample mean divided by 2 sigma, divided by 2 sigma. But the N from this curve, we call this n star. That's right. The n star is calculated from the curve. And then you can solve for n after you know n star from the curve. So if you know d, you know beta, you can interpret or determine n star, and then you solve for n after you substitute n star in this equation. And this for the curve, except you did for two sides with this alpha. Two sides with this alpha. This is one side, this alpha. This one side, this alpha. Okay, for the kind of the catalyst of the experiment in the previous example, we support if so catalyst to produce a mean yield different from the mean yield of the catalyst one is by 4%. The difference from the yield of the second catalyst compared to the first catalyst is 4%. We would like to reject the known hypothesis with probability at least 0.85. Reject the known hypothesis, that means accept the known hypothesis is 0.15. This is the beta error. What is the sample size? You know beta for this case. You know beta, and then you know D by calculate D equal to delta. Delta is 4%. The yield is in percent, that's right. 4% divided by 2. You know SP, but for this case, use the SP instead of sigma. You then 0.74. That's right, 7.74 beta is 0.15. You interpret from this. That's right. You get N approximately 20. This is 0.74, and beta is 0.15. You can read the N around 20. So you get the N is 20, but N is it for N star. That's right. You know N star equal to 2N plus 1. 2N minus 1, sorry. N star is 2N minus 1. Okay, you get the 2N minus 1. And then you solve for N. 2N, N star equal to 2N minus 1, and N equal to N star plus 1 divided by 2. You get 10.5 or approximately 11. That's like N1 equal to N2 is equal to 11 for this example. And also for this case, we have to talk about the for known and unknown value. We have to calculate the confidence interval in the same manner, right? We talk about the known value. For this case, unknown value, we use T instead of Z, that's right. For this case, it's equal variance. We use T statistic by SP. And also for the formula for this mean lower and upper limit, follow this equation, that's right. This is the lower T alpha over 2N1 plus N2 minus 2, the SP. This parameter calculate from this equation. This is the upper, is a plus this minus. It's the same parameter, the same parameter. And then you can calculate the upper and lower limit. The conclusion is same. I talked to you previously. If the difference lower is minus sign, upper is minus sign, that means mu 1 is not equal to mu 2, and mu 1 less than mu 2. That's right. If both side is positive sign, both side is positive sign, that means mu 1 not equal to mu 2, then also mu 1 greater than mu 2. If the lower is negative sign, upper is positive sign. We can use mu 1 equal to mu 2. That's it, mu 1 equal to mu 2. For the case of variance 1 is not equal to variance 2. If variance 1 is not equal to variance 2, that's right. For this case, we use this formula. We use this formula. It's similar because it's different because the degree of freedom is different. Degree of freedom is different, and we use the variance 1, variance 2. But for this case, degree of freedom is that side, and also we use SP. Quite the equation quite similar, but not the same 100%. Right. Okay, for this case, we check the article that has that weight and has that material. This report analysis of the weight of calcium in standard cement and cement dope with lead. It's like we have to compare the weight percent of calcium in the cement and the cement with dope with the lead. That's right. Reduce the level of calcium would indicate that the hydration mechanism in the cement is blocked and would allow water to attack in various locations in the cement structure. Okay, for this case, The 10 sample of standard cement had an average weight percent at 90, and a sample standard deviation at 5. And 15 sample of lead dope cement had average at 87, and standard deviation is 4 for this case. Okay. We will assume that the weight percent calcium is normal distribution. This means 95% confidence interval of the difference between mu1 and mu2 for this case. Mu1 and mu2 for this case. Okay. For this case, we we assume have the same standard deviation. Both population that I had the same standard deviation. For this case, you use the first formula. For variant 1 equal to variant 2. That's right, we use to SP. That's right, we call it by SP. You know, N1 variant 1, N2 variant 2, you get SP is 19.52. Okay, and then you use the formula to calculate lower and upper limit. This is the T alpha over 2 degree of freedom N1 plus N2 minus 2, and SP, you substitute SP here. That's right, you substitute SP here. Okay, and then you calculate the upper and lower limit. You substitute x bar 1, x bar 2, SPN 1, N 2, and then you get the limit is between minus 0.72 and 6.72. For this case, I talked to you that because it includes 0 or it's between minus and positive. That means mu 1 and mu 2 is equal. What does it mean that there is no the evidence that show that the different cement between the standard cement and cement with dope with lead. Not different the percent of calcium. That's right. Not different the percent of calcium by 95% confidence interval. Okay. I will stop the lecture now and we continue this lecture for the next lecture. We talk about the static inference also, but we will check the pair test and the variance and also the last one proportion. Okay. Thank you for attention.